there, the president not seeming to be fazed by what happened in Washington today. Two special guests joining us now on set, Tim Rosales, Andrew Acosta, Democrat, Republican. Gentlemen, thanks for being here. We appreciate this.
Thank you.
Just a little bit to talk about, right? What happened today.
Sure.
Okay, so we all knew this day was going to come, and we knew how the vote was going to happen, but that didn't stop hours of debate and each side sort of grandstanding and laying out, you know, their thoughts. Good move for Pelosi?
I think Pelosi had to do what she had to do. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's a good move. I think, as you said, I wouldn't say maybe grandstanding. A lot of folks reading talking points.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, a vote that I think most people could have predicted a month ago what it was going to look like. And, you know, a handful, you know, two or three that shook off on the Democratic side. But that's about it.
What do you think about Tulsi Gabbard just saying present and not voting yay or nay? Was that...
I think she's beats her own drum.
Okay.
Yeah, she does. I mean, she's from Hawaii. She does her own thing.
Okay. I just was like, wait, all right. Okay. We're not going to do it. All right. So, Tim, you are familiar with this process.
A little bit,
we've had you on a couple of times, and we've talked about your history. You were working for a member of Congress when Bill Clinton was impeached, a Republican member of Congress. I believe Adam Schiff holds his seat now.
Correct. Yep.
Wow. Okay. So, just take us through, for folks that aren't familiar, because it's, first of all, the subject matter is confusing, mm-hmm. and then you have this process that can be confusing to people. So where do we go from here?
Well, I think, you know, a lot of people are gonna wake up tomorrow and say, well, Donald Trump's still president,
mm-hmm.
but I thought
right.
he was impeached. No, there's a process, right? Impeachment happens in the House, and then you have a trial, you know, in the Senate. But, you know, Andrew and I were talking about it. The House still has to select managers or prosecutors to take this trial to the Senate, and what that looks like. Is a decision that the House is going to have to make. And, you know, then in terms of the rules, in with the Clinton impeachment, the Chief Justice presided over the trial, William Rehnquist at the time. This time, you know, John Roberts mm-hmm. is the Chief Justice. You know, will he preside? The Senate Majority Leader at the time with Clinton was Trent Lott. He worked closely with Tom Daschle. And in fact, there was a little bit of push and pull between the House, even though it was controlled by Republicans, mm-hmm. and the Senate, who was controlled by the Republicans at the time under Clinton. This time you've got a House controlled by Democrats, mm-hmm. a Senate controlled by Republicans, still some animosity there, obviously, between the two sides. But how does, you know, Mitch McConnell, who is the majority leader there in the Senate, what rules, how does he operate this Senate trial? Because he's got a lot of discretion here, and he's already said he will, you know, back up the president.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is not Trent Lott, Daschle,
days are over.
I mean, this is a guy that went on Fox and basically said, I'm gonna do whatever the president says, I'm mm-hmm. gonna program at the White House. And, you know, Nancy Pelosi came out tonight after she was, after the vote, and said, well, we might not send the articles of impeachment over yet because we want a fair trial, and what he's saying would not make it a fair trial.
Mm-hmm.
So. You know, I mean, one thing that Donald Trump said is the Republican Party is unified like it's ever been before, and he's right. And you saw it from the vote, and you can see what's happening. Folks who have crossed Donald Trump are gone.
Mm-hmm.
The folks who are left are not going to cross Donald Trump. They know that this is his party, and Mitch McConnell is going to do exactly what Donald Trump says he has to do to make this thing go the way that the president wants it to go.
And this is going to play into 2020. I mean, this
Absolutely.
Is just the beginning.
Yeah, and we were just talking, there's a Democratic debate tomorrow for president,
mm-hmm.
and you know, it'll be a three-hour debate, and I'm not sure how many people are gonna lock in for 3 hours to watch a mm-hmm. debate for president after watching some of this, you know, this theater go on today,
mm-hmm.
and then spill right into Hanukkah and Christmas.
So, right. and part of what we do, I mean, we run political campaigns,
right.
and a big part of running political campaigns is you wanna see in anything, who moves, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's a big question we always ask, right? Okay, who does this move? Because you have one base and then you've got the other base and it's really the mushy middle. So looking at what happened here with impeachment, again, who moves? We see from all of the public opinion research going on, you know, nationally, Republicans are locked in, you've got the Democratic base locked in, then you've got a number of people in the middle. Are they moving?
Mm-hmm.
And I think what we're learning is that, no, they're not moving.
Because this just seems like it's white noise at this point from just folks that I talk to that are
sure.
not involved in news, not involved in politics. They're not super dialed into
well,
the
I think
day-to-day.
And I, it sounded like the Democrats were hoping that this would have the same, you know, Nixonian mm-hmm. type of appeal that people would watch it on TV and snap into, you know, a new judgment of a president who's done wrong. And clearly that's not happened. Mm-hmm. And you could see it from today. And even some of the recent public polling has showed that Trump's numbers have actually improved and it has an opposite effect. And I think the mistake the Democrats made on some of this is clearly some in the party wanted to impeach him the day he got elected. Mm-hmm. And they said it. And that's what you heard over and over today, mm-hmm. is that Democrats have been looking to impeach him. They've been trying to find an excuse. And there are some in the party who have been trying to find an excuse. And unfortunately, that gets played up more than the thoughtful, let's look for the evidence mm-hmm. and let's make this, you know, a trial. And that piece seems to get, and in this day and age where people get their news, very few people are watching. They're either watching Fox or they're watching CNN.
Right. You know, I was watching an interview with Leslie Stahl about a month ago. She was being interviewed on the circus on Showtime, and she was talking about the parallels of what's happening now and Nixon. And she said back then when I was covering this, she's like, there were three networks
right.
and all of our stories at 5 o'clock, whenever we went live, we all sounded the same.
Yep.
Tonight, you can turn on MSNBC, you can turn on Fox News, you can turn on CNN, you can turn on us. And everyone's gonna be saying something different.
Or
people are gonna be interpreting it differently.
Or you can watch CNN and listen to Talking Heads, or you can turn on Fox and watch a Trump rally.
Right.
And you, and what you have here is the not only the 24-hour news cycle, mm-hmm. it's become the 24-hour campaign,
mm-hmm.
and that's what you have with what's going on. It's a 24-hour campaign, and for most people, you know, we live and breathe this stuff. Mm-hmm. I think, you know, you go onto Twitter and you see kind of the political nerd universe unite, and everybody you know talks about this like it's the only thing going on in the mm-hmm. world. For most people out there, real people, you know, they're worrying how to get their kids to soccer practice. You know, they've got Christmas presents to buy. They're, you know, vacation plans and, you know, how they're going to drive to go see relatives and all kinds of stuff. You know, this is not in their top five issues of things going on in their life. It may be for all of us, but, you know, really what we have to do, and this is caution for Republicans too, is to look at the, you know, don't get so wrapped up in kind of a victory lap or to, you know, rally around, you know, President Trump and like that there's, you know, they can do no wrong.
Mm-hmm.
The fact is people care about what's going on with them. Voters are selfish. And unless either party, and this is, you know, looking at 2020, whomever is able to talk to individuals and break it down to the very basics of how they can best serve those individual voters or those individual families, they're the ones who are going to be successful in 2020. And if either party gets too wrapped up in these kind of big national, you know, debates mm-hmm. over things that you know really happen in a Twitter echo chamber,
right? Quid pro quos.
They're
going to
come out on the losing end.
Well, this will do one thing. It'll continue to drive down regular folks and their views of Washington, D.C.
Mm-hmm.
Because right now they think Congress is horrible and they can't get anything done, and they're going to say, got it, knew
right.
it, you know, next thing, like tell us what's happening next. Because none of this is shocking that mm-hmm. there's gridlock in Washington, D.C.
So do you think that this, I mean, you talked about it a little bit, this benefits the president?
It's too early to tell. I mean, I think it's too, you know, here's the problem with all this. We don't know how it benefits because we don't know who he's running against.
Yet. Okay.
You know, so there's a whole, and we will, you know, I'm sure most voters in California don't know, but they're going to start voting in March mm-hmm. in California, and then they will start voting in Iowa a month before that.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot that's going to start coming into focus.
And honestly, by June, will we even be talking about impeachment anymore,
well,
the way this cycle is?
Yeah, and the president, to kind of his administration's credit, they've been picking up some wins here over mm-hmm. the last couple of weeks. USMCA on trade agreements, prescription drugs, and healthcare. They've been picking up little wins that are getting, right now, kind of undershadowed by the overshadowing of impeachment. But, you know, come August, September, I mean, these are things that they will, you know, be able to trot out. And, you know, those are issues that people care about. So, you know, there's a lot of things going on right now that, you know, we just don't know how they're going to turn out in September.
It's funny because the Democrats are trying to get wins as well. Mm-hmm. And I saw one of the members of Congress on, speaking of Twitter, highlighting all the good work he's done, you know, and a lot of it's meetings and, you know, it's not, as Tim said, it's not relevant to voters that he's making their lives better.
Right. It's not prescription drugs.
Yeah,
it's more
process. He's
right.
doing his job, which is fine. But if that's all you have to talk about is, I met with a bunch of people and I went to town halls, I'm not sure that what's going to is doing campaigns for a living. I'm not sure that's going to be the thing that's going to move voters to elect you. Because at some point they're going to say, okay, what else have you been doing besides impeaching a president?
Right. So, okay, so now I'm going to ask you guys to try to see who is, at this point, I mean, hopefully we have everyone that's running for president that is announced. No one else is going to try to join. Well,
I think it's too late to get on the ballot here. So, right. Yeah, I think we're running out of time.
Who is, in your opinion, that Democrat that can take on the president who says, look, I have all this ammunition. They're trying to impeach me. But like you said, I'm getting USMCA done. You know, I'm fighting with China on trade. Who do you think that person is right now as we speak?
I'd have to say Biden, okay. Even though I've seen other candidates and I'm impressed by them. I just think with what we have going forward, I think he has the best, he's the ability to sort of bring a bigger coalition together and take on the president. But you know, at the end of the day, it's up to the Democrats, and we're really good at you know, shooting ourselves. So
okay.
We'll see.
Biden?
I think Biden, if I was on the president's campaign, mm-hmm. Biden would worry me.
Okay.
You know, I think that's...
Well, clearly he did, because
yeah. Right, right.
Ukraine... But that's what we're talking about here.
That's what we got here.
Exactly. So, yeah, Biden would worry me, I think, from a political standpoint, because I think he can get some of those Trump voters that you know, voted for the president in 2016 that didn't go for Hillary. But, you know, Biden's a completely different candidate.
All right, gentlemen, we got to leave it there. Thanks so much for being here. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.